गुरुर् ब्रह्मा गुरुर् विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुः साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे Having told who is fit for self-inquiry and what is self-inquiry and enumerated that the various stages of life are not an impediment for a student who is mature for inquiry. Now, see sometimes you know everything yet some doubt remains. Masters like Ramana Maharishi, Shankaracharya, when they compose something, it's a complete thought. We don't have the capacity to sing from beginning till end. Our style is, what should I think about today? I don't know, Bhagavad Gita chapter 1, but it's too long. We're going to chapter 15, it's too short. What should I do? Wherever by God's grace this page opens, this is confusing. So I close the book again and again I open. I don't understand Sanskrit. In this page only Sanskrit is there. Then again I close. Third time lucky, you know. Siyavar Ramchandra ki jai, katai. And then he opens and something is written there. He doesn't know in what was before it and what is after it. He just sees that one line. That was so divine. He has got understood nothing. But that momentary something strikes him, but it's not a complete thought. When you study the scriptures, from the beginning till end, your mind is formatted in such a way by the teacher, by the scripture, or by the words of the master, that no iota of doubt is left behind. And you have seen from yesterday, as we are progressing, if you have come to the previous retreats, every chapter is progressing. You take Vivek Chudamani, every chapter is progressing. Now we are at the man of wisdom. What are his signs? So, don't think you are intelligent, more intelligent than the scriptures. Don't think you are more intelligent than the Mahatmas, whose words these are. Because they are established at a higher level, they have a better vision of the total scheme. You are looking at now. You are looking at only what is in front of you. They are looking at the total. So now, having removed the doubt of birth also, many times ladies have come, Swamiji, I went to that teacher and they said, I will not teach you. I said, why? They will not teach. No, ladies should not chant Om. Ladies should not do puja. Ladies should not do havan. Ladies should not read Upanishads. I said, okay. Then why you have come to me after knowing that? Swamiji, you are liberal. ऐसे भी होता है. अब रमण महर्षि इज सेइंग ही हैज गॉट नो प्रॉब्लम इन टीचिंग एनीवन, इजंट इट? सो दीस डाउट्स रिमेन. सपोज शी हैड नॉट कम एंड स्पोकन, और सम लेडीज आर देयर, दे वांट टू लर्न वैदिक चैंटिंग, प्रोबब्ली यू आल्सो वेंट थ्रू दैट, दे डोंट वांट टू टीच. व्हाट डू यू डू देन? दैट मींस योर अर्ज इज देयर समवेयर. इट कम्स अक्रॉस, यू कम अक्रॉस अ पर्सन हु इज एबल टू, हु इज रेडी टू टीच यू. सो सिमिलरली these doubts have been removed about our birth, about our lineage, about our ashram, whether we are in brahmachari, grahastha, vanaprastha or this. Now removing all that, now we come to the ultimate. What is the ultimate? On cutting the knot. Granthi bheda kathanam. This is the 9th chapter. 9 is a complete number. 9 is a complete number. And here the chapter is called Granthi. Granthi is a knot. Knot is like this. This is a cloth and you are tying a knot with the same cloth and you have created a knot. So before it was a plain piece of cloth, now it has got a knot in it. This is the knot that is there in us also. All you have to do is pull at two ends and sort it out. It's not a knot, how will I do it? I need a pin to open it. No. All you need to do is give it attention. If you give it attention, it will vanish. So what are the two ends? Here it is told in this. To cut the knot. First verse. चतुर्दशेष्टमे रात्रौ महर्षि पृष्टवानहम् ग्रन्थिभेदं समुद्दिश्य यत्र विदुषां यत्र संशयः. On the night of the 14th August, I put a question to Maharishi, Bhagwan Ramana Maharishi, regarding Granthi Bheda. Bheda means to pierce through. Granthi means the knot. How do you pierce through the knot? On which even the learned have doubts. So if you go to a chemistry teacher and ask about physics question, and he is on his trip of that I know everything, can he guide you properly? You go to a man, you go to a male doctor and you ask him about childbirth, can he tell you? He can be a doctor, he has read everything, but he has got no experience. So his knowledge will always be less than a person who has experienced childbirth, isn't it? So you go to a mother, you don't have to go to a doctor, explain, they will explain. Similarly, we go one page here, one page there, not complete text, one page here, one page there. Sometimes we go to this satsang, sometimes we go to that, sometimes we go to this master, sometimes we go to the... We are as if, what you call, muh maar rahe hain, ko kya bolte hain, chonch maar rahe hain. We are just pecking the information from here, from there, from there, from there. Such a person becomes very rare person is there who can get the complete thought, because in the end answer is inside. If that thought triggers it, it's good. But never one must feel that they are already there. So better to go through a complete thought from beginning till end, so that a complete scheme is presented to our mind, so that the mind does not have any doubt or unanswered questions left behind. So here he has come to see. Even in Upanishads, I told you the other day, in Upanishads also the students, they are themselves great masters, learned masters, scientists in Upanishads. But scientists of what? Masters of what? Of the world. They are masters of yoga, masters of pranayama, masters of Raja Yoga, masters of having got the space, air, fire, water, earth in their control. They got so many siddhis, but there is one thing lacking in them. That's why they have come to a teacher. Because that all these powers, all this success in their life, all the analysis in their life has not given them the unadulterated happiness. Whatever happiness they have got, it has come and it has gone away. And in that journey they came, experimented everything, but still it is eluding them. So they come to a master in Upanishads. Why they came? Because they know he is established in that permanent one. So whom should I get it? From the scriptures, or should I get it from the master who is experienced what is given in the scriptures?
Master.
So scriptures also should be studied from those who have practiced it in their life, not from videos and audios. That is good. After listening, you listen to it again. But knowledge is always transferred from consciousness to consciousness. It is not transferred from inertness to consciousness. So CD, MP3 cannot transfer knowledge to you. It can give you information. It can make you feel good, but it cannot, the transfer of knowledge cannot take place. Transfer of knowledge does not require the medium of mind in between. You understand what I'm saying? It does not require the medium of mind. Whether you think or you don't think, it's up to you. Next verse. Samakarnya mama prashnam. Ramano Bhagavan Rishihi. Dhyatva Divyena Bhavena. Kinchidaha Mahamaha. The effulgent Bhagwan Sri Ramana Maharishi listened to my question, thought for a while, and in his divine way spoke. See, what is this Granti Bheda? Granti, what is this knot? Granti is the knot, Bheda is the piercing. What is this Granti Bheda? What is its implication? What will happen if I pierce this knot? First thing is, I don't even know that there is a knot. Now you're telling me, now I'm starting to think. And if I say, then what is the implication? Oh, you will vanish. Who are you? Immediately fear. No. So here he says, anyway, what Bhagavan Ramana Maharishi says, we'll look at that and then I'll explain. So he says, in the third verse he says, Sharirasyatmanaschapi Sambandho Granthi Ruchyate Sambandhe Naiva Shariram Bhavati Jnanam Atmanaha. The nexus, Shariras Yatma Atmanaschapi Sambandho. Sambandho means relationship, identification. Granthi Ruchyate is called as the Granthi. Identification between what and what? Here it says, the nexus of the body and the self is called the Granthi. Body, Annamaya, cross body, vital air body, mental body, intellectual body, and the causal body. All these put together. This body, who produced it? Did you produce it? Parents produced it. They produced the hardware. You entered, then software came. So, hardware is the bulb. Electricity is the energy or the source, and when it expresses through the bulb, what comes about? Light. Light is the mind. Electricity cannot know all the objects illumined. Only mind can know. But without electricity, light cannot be. Without electricity, bulb has got no meaning. Exactly the same manner. Yesterday I was somewhere, I think I mentioned this point, that these two are absolutely opposite qualities. Body is quality of inertness, consciousness is of the quality of knowledge. How come these two, one which is conscious and one which is inert, they get identified, they come together? They can never come together, yet they are seen to be together. here now this whole point of how they come together, this is the unique approach of Ramana Maharishi. If you understand this, a lot of cobwebs will be gone. So the nexus of the body and the self is called the granthi. It is only by this connection with the self that one is aware of the body. So how does this take place? How does this come about? The body is insentient, whereas consciousness is awareness. Consciousness is knowledge. Is knowledge itself. And when this body is in connection with this consciousness, just like, for example, let's see, ocean is not the moon, isn't it? If a moon is not there, can you see the waves on the ocean? No. But then moon comes, and what do you see? You see the reflection of the moon. The light is sparkling there. And in that light, or because of the sparkles of the moonlight, you can see the waves, isn't it? But can you have, can you see the, that's one example, okay? Otherwise, no example is complete. That is the problem. So similarly, in us, this knot is the expression of this pure consciousness as awareness. And what is that awareness? As I. And this awareness as I can only come about under one condition. The appearance of this I thought can happen only under one condition. You have forgotten yourself. The consciousness has identified with the body, and for it to identify with the body, it has to forget itself. And that is called ignorance. So what is the first expression of ignorance? I. I is the first expression. Then that again multiplies further, that is a different, but we are going to the root. We want to cut the knot. This is the knot of ignorance. Shankaracharya tells it in a different way. He says, Agyan kama karma, this is the knot. Agyan, ignorance leads to, ignorance of our own essential nature leads to desire. And desire leads to action. And action again produces results as memories, and you remain in the cycle of ignorance. So that cycle of ignorance, avidya kama karma, that cycle has to be broken. For that, something outside this cycle has to be thought about. In whose presence this cycle is going on, that has to be thought about. Very similar here also. So here he says that source of consciousness, the heart, that it becomes active. So the body becomes active only when it is touched by the conscious principle. Again, another example, iron filings are there and they are inert by nature. There's no activity in them. Bulb was also inert. Similarly, mind is also, body is also inert. When we say body, it's the gross body, subtle body, causal body, or the panchakoshas. That is inert. Iron filings are inert. They come in the presence of magnet. They have not even touched the magnet. They are only in the presence of the magnet. Activity is generated within the iron filings. How come? exactly the same way. Within this body also, this body is inert, but it's active right now, isn't it? How come this activity is generated? Because it is in the proximity of the self, conscious self. And we are not, we haven't realized our conscious self. We have not realized our conscious self at this moment. We are considering ourselves to be the body. So where will our inquiry begin from? In the body only. Thinking about conscious self, you are not ready to accept only. Even though it is your natural state, you are not ready to accept, because your actions show that. So here Bhagavan is saying that the aspirant, the seeker, if he wants liberation, it is necessary for him to cut this knot of ignorance. In the fourth verse he says, Shariram jadame tasyad, Atma chaitanya mishyate, Ubhayorapi sambandho, Vijnane nanumiyate. He says the body is insentient, the self is pure awareness, the connection between the two is deduced through the intellect. So how do you know that there is a connection, even though there is no connection? Because we have got something called intellect. Only human beings have it, nobody else. Nobody can do self-inquiry if you are not a human being. And who is a human being? I keep repeating this. Who is a human being? He who has his mind under his control is called Manushya. If your mana ayushya, mana mind, ayushya in control, if your mind is not under control, you are qualified to be called an animal even though functioning through human body. Oh my God, we are all disqualified. Why? Because we just overeat. Animals don't overeat. Animals never overeat. So that is one qualification. So here he says, the body is the matter and self is the self-awareness or the self-consciousness. It's pure consciousness. The link between the two, that which is inert and that which is conscious, that which is sentient and that which is insentient, that which is solid and that which is pure knowledge. What is linking the two? Is the space linking the two? Is God linking the two? What is that link? Breath is linking. Man can live without breath also. You can go into samadhi, you are not breathing. So where is the, that link is, that is for the beginning seeker. Wo bachcha hai, KG mein raho. Uske liye 6th chapter mein aana chahiye. You missed that yesterday. No, missed last retreat. Breath is required, but it is only to control the mind. Breath can also take you to samadhi. But breath is not required to be existing. Ghosts exist, they don't breathe. It's okay. You're thinking in the right direction. So here he says, so the body is insentient and the consciousness is sentient. The body is inert, the pure consciousness is not inert, meaning it is full of knowledge. So how come these two opposite qualities of two opposing things, I don't want to use any other word, these two opposites, how come they are coming together?
It's happening as an eternal phenomenon.
You know, leave it. Yes, that is from Shiva Shakti point of view. We are going beyond that. Yes, it is happening as an eternal phenomenon. But we want to break through that phenomenon so that we see Jnaneshwar Maharaj, why is he able to write about Shiva Shakti phenomenon?
Because he's beyond
it. He has gone beyond it. We want to go beyond it so that we can also see this phenomenon as the Leela of the Divine. Right now,
it's out of ignorance.
Catches. How does this too come? Yes, it is out of ignorance. So how do you know where ignorance began? Ignorance is beginningless, isn't it? Truth is beginningless, ignorance is also beginningless. But truth is limitless. Ignorance has an end when the knowledge takes place. So even though we are inquiring in ignorance because we are using our mind, we are using our intellect, we are using our speech, we are using this body for pranayama, etc. All this is happening under the purview of ignorance only. So how come I am thinking in ignorance and I want to get out of ignorance?
Atmic
principle is not ignorance.
No, I mean you're asking the question, I'm answering what is it that's connecting it?
No, atmic principle is not connecting. Atmic principle is, seems that the atmic principle is connected to this body because two are different. At the time of death, something leaves.
Yeah.
People see that, isn't it? What has got, but at the same time, we know pure consciousness never goes anywhere. That experience that we are having, that when the body dies, something has left, it's a foolish conclusion. Nothing has left. Nothing has left. Then what has happened? If that is the state conclusion, then can you say when the wave has died, the water has left? Can you come to that conclusion? That the wave has died, water has left. That's why the wave is not expressing. It's not possible. So what has happened when the person has died?
It's merged into the totality.
What has happened? What will happen when these walls break? What will happen to this space? Will it go and join?
No,
or it is already?
It's already there.
Okay. So what will happen to the consciousness which seems to be trapped in this body, matter? Will it escape? It is everywhere. But are you experiencing its everywhere-ness? What is the point of that ignorance? Where does the ignorance first express itself? Will be the link, no?
The mind?
Intellect. And what happens in the intellect? Too many thoughts in intellect. What happens? The I thought appears there in intellect. All other thoughts appear in the mind. I thought appears in the intellect. You could see, body is gross, breath is subtle, mind is subtler, intellect is even subtler, more polished. Therefore, that consciousness is able to reflect itself in the intellect. In mind, it is not able to reflect. Or you can take it as in this manner. You see this wall, so many bulbs are there. The light is everywhere, isn't it? But certain parts of the wall or the ceiling are more bright than the other parts. Which parts are brighter? Which is closest to the source? Or that is first thing. Second, that which has got the ability to reflect the light. that curtain is not able to reflect the light as bright as the ceiling. Why? It is dark. So intellect is so polished that it is able to reflect the consciousness. That is a natural phenomena which is going on. That reflected consciousness, that in technical terms it is called as chidabhasa, reflected consciousness, then it gets, and that is going on. If it goes on, no problem. But foolishly, it starts thinking, I am the body. I am. First it decides that. This I comes in the intellect. And I am the body, the idea called body comes in the mind. I have an intellect comes in the mind. I am a breathing, without breathing I cannot live comes in the mind. Birth and death come in the mind. For whom? For the I. I is owning all these thoughts, isn't it? So all other thoughts are in the mind. I thought is in the intellect. So we have to refine ourselves so much that we are able to catch this eye and pierce through it by finding what its source is. This is the procedure, this is the dissection operation that has been suggested of cutting the knot. Then he says, see, when the consciousness is expressing through the body and there is no awareness of the body, is it possible? Consciousness is expressing through the body and the body is not available to be perceived. Is it possible? Deep sleep. Which other state? leave them aside. Nirvikalpa samadhi. In nirvikalpa samadhi, that consciousness is expressing and body thought has not come in your mind. Healthy state. Healthy state. So when does the I thought come? So there is no I thought. You are in nirvikalpa. Nirvikalpa itself means zero thought, and you are consciousness. So when does the I thought come?
For I to come,
idam has to be there. I doesn't come. I. Oh, then what? Nobody says I whole day. You don't keep going around saying I. Then when does I come? Only when body conscious. When does body consciousness come? I'm answer the question. When does the body identification happen? So think now. Even at least logically, that you are in nirvikalpa samadhi or you are in sleep, you are unaware of the body. What has to happen in order for you to be aware of the body, that I am the body? Thought must come. That is, but what has to happen? Huh? Sleep has to be broken, okay, from samadhi. Why will it break? Identification will take place because of, I'm trying to get, take you there. Thank God. Who said? Usha. Self-forgetfulness. Kitne ghoom ghaam ke dekho, phir paake pahunchte hain. Our mind is going in all. Because we have forgotten ourselves, we fall into association with something other than self. to get into association with someone else, the first thing that erupts is the I, and subsequently, immediately, spontaneously, along with the I, the corresponding thought of what it is associating with, that also appears. Because I cannot appear by itself. It has to appear with in association. So someone was saying duality, it's correct, but what is the reason duality has come about? Recognize this about yourself. Every morning you have an opportunity to catch this point. Every night when you go to sleep, you have an opportunity to catch this point. Between every two breaths, you have the opportunity to catch this point. Between two thoughts, you have the opportunity to catch this point. So the whole mature student means he is able to stay with this thought for a long period of time so that he can see the mechanics of how the I thought is coming and dissolving. Right now we are so busy in our mind that we are not able to, we are understanding, but we don't have the staying power to see the thought go back to its source. That's where we are lacking. Uske liye stamina bana padta hai. To make that stamina, you have to purify your mind. To purify the mind, you have to detach from the world. And how do you purify the mind? Not just by detaching from the world, by doing pranayam, pranabandhana, lina manasam, etc. The different exercises which our Bhagavan Ramana gave us. So in this manner, the ego individuality is the link, the knot which has to be cut, since the nexus, the I, partakes of both the characteristics of the consciousness of the heart from which it has risen and the matter, the body with which it is associated with, and becomes a bridge back to the consciousness. So who is this I that we are considering ourselves? I say I am conscious, and I say I am the body also. Which one am I? So I have borrowed from both. I have taken some qualities of the body, and I have taken, what is that? Inertness. And I have taken the knowledge of the self. And I have imposed that knowledge of the self or consciousness of the self on the body. I have mixed it. The example will be given next, how it has been mixed. And then I am now considering, I am a conscious person. Please respect me. Don't consider me as a doormat. I have got to do sadhana to realize. Sab drama, sab phaltu chal raha hai. Yet you have to do it, isn't it? But understand, this is where the error has taken place. That you have forgotten yourself, because you have forgotten, if I forget myself, automatically my attention goes somewhere. The attention went to the body. Imagine the water forgets itself and its attention goes to the wave. And he says, oh, I am the wave, please help me. So many waves are trying to come and kill me. Water says, are bevkoof, you are infinite. Nay, 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 that you may be, but I am limited, you know. From water's point of view, he knows wave is water. From guru's point of view, he knows student is realized. But from student's point of view, poor little me, I'm a seeker. Why though so much hardships are coming my way only? Have I committed any sins? Is my prarabdha bad? Why God's grace is not falling upon me? Complaining personalities, big ego. Happy personalities, zero ego, less ego. Realized personalities, zero ego. So what is the link between the consciousness and the body? This ego, this I thought, who is owning everything, who is identifying with everything, except what it should identify with. It should identify with the infinite. Instead, he has taken the qualities of the infinite. What is that? ajanma, nitya, shuddha, buddha, mukta, swarupa, and he wants all those things to happen with the body. So start yoga, start pranayama. I want to live 100 years. What are you going to do living 100 years? Be a problem to everyone. Purpose is not to live 100 years. Purpose of life is to recognize that you are infinite, eternal, not as a body, as consciousness. Body has come, it will go one day. As much as you may try to make it immortal, it will never become immortal. So what are you going to do? So pranayama is not for making the body healthy and eternal. If that is the goal, then you are losing the plot. Pranayama's purpose is to purify the mind. That's all. Chitta Shuddhi. Chitta Shuddhi. See? So our whole approach to this thing called spirituality itself is corrupted many times. Teacher tells something, we understand something. Scriptures tell something, we understand. Yes, yes, yes. And baad mein, when I hear some people talking, I said, I didn't say that. Scriptures didn't say that. But they are very convincingly, they are talking about whatever they are saying. But that is not what was told. It didn't happen here, don't worry. You are looking at each other, who said that? Huh?
So are we an unconscious body?
Aye.
Are we almost like an unconscious
body? Can never be conscious. Body can never be conscious. Body is dead matter. At any given moment, appearing to be alive. Bulb is always dead, appearing to be giving light because of its association with electricity. Body, bulb cannot have association. Electricity is having association, isn't it? So same way, this body is having, or the consciousness, they have both come into association with each other, and a third thing is called, which is existing in its own absence. Just like you can touch the bulb and have an experience, you can touch the electricity, have a shocking experience, but you cannot have experience of the light other than that it's illuminating. But where is light? You look for it, either you will reach the bulb or you will reach the electricity. And where is the electricity expressing through in this bulb as light? In the filament. The filament in us is the intellect, where the I thought appears. That is the filament. But intellect is also inert. It's only a curl of wire, that's all, with a cathode and anode. And the electricity passes through, suddenly that electricity becomes light. But what is light? Nothing. It's existing in its own absence. Similarly, this ego, this I, is also existing in its own absence. It has got no reality. You cannot have a reality of ego and say, this is true, isn't it? I am, and I'm the individual, and now I want to know the real me. How can you be real and you know the real you? There can be only one real. Because one real alone is infinite, eternal, unborn, all-pervasive. You cannot have one eternal reality and one individual reality. You cannot have water separate to wave. You cannot have water separate to wave. Think. So similarly, this. So. Water, what is water? Water. What is wave? Water. So what will be the ego there? If water is water and wave is also water, then what is the ego there? If wave could think. Its waveness. Its waveness, that I am a wave, is the ego. So now, apply it on yourself. Everything is reality. Everything is reality. So what is making you not be that? The I am-ness. And I-amness has come about on account of what? Your association with the body. This I-amness will not exist if body is you disassociate with the body. This I-amness will not come. The I-thought will not appear. You are looking at me as if what I am saying. You have to slow down the thoughts. I will again take you to your sleep experience. Is there a I-thought appearing when you go to sleep? Is there a I-thought appearing before you go to sleep? Is it appearing? But there the I-thought is contemplating on sleep. That I-thought dissolves its existence by merging into the sleep or getting sucked into sleep. If you can bring that about consciously, sleep means zero mind. If you can bring about the entire process of going to sleep without going to sleep, is what Ramana Maharishi is talking about. It's that simple. Simple. So many words and simple. Yes. Because you are already practicing it. Do it with awareness and it will, you are there. Now, where are we? The fifth verse. Chaitanya Chaya Ya Vish. One moment. Chaitanya Chayaya Shlishtam Shariram Tat Cheshtate Shariram Tat Cheshtate Nidra Daugrahana Bhavad Uhyate Sthana Matmanaha. Tat, tat means child. Oh child, enveloped by the diffused light of pure awareness, the body functions owing to non-apprehension. So, when it says enveloped by the diffused light of pure awareness, the body functions. Now think, are you in the direct light of sunlight functioning, or you are functioning in the diffused light of sunlight? Explain to others what you mean. You understood?
I think the direct light, we are not exactly outside direct sunlight, but because the sun is there, we are all alive. Anyway, that's how I feel.
It's not focused on any one particular part of our
body. You go out of the house.
It'll be all over.
Are you in direct sunlight? If you go out of this room, now sunshine has come out. Are you in the direct sunlight or diffuse sunlight? Why?
Because
you're operating from the mind. Yaar, spirituality mein aa jaate ho. Simple question hai. Once you go out of this room and you stand in the sun, under the sun, and the sun is shining, are you under direct sunlight or diffuse sunlight?
Direct.
No. घुमा दिया. नो, आई कंफ्यूज यू नाउ. वॉच, आई कंफ्यूज यू. देयर सी, फर्स्ट कंफ्यूजन. सनलाइट हैज गॉट नो कलर. इफ यू गो इन टू स्पेस, सनलाइट हैज नो कलर. इट हैज गॉट नो रेज. इट इज डार्क इन कलर. It's not dark, it has got no quality. Now, when do you see sunlight? Only when it reflects on something, only then you come to know. So you are seeing sunlight in the Earth's atmosphere. Where is it reflecting? On all the particles hanging in the air. So is it direct or diffused?
Diffused.
Thank you, sir. Conclusion aa gaya. I'm not a science student, par itna pata hai. It's reflected light. It's not direct light. Exactly the same way. Exactly the same way. The consciousness, when it is expressing through the body, it is diffused consciousness. Consciousness. It is not direct consciousness. It is not the original one. When you see the full moon, just like the original moon in the waters of the ocean, it is not the original, but having all qualities of the original. The color, the form, the light, the brightness, it's all like the original, but it's not the original. You are seeing it through a medium. Similarly, this consciousness that I'm experiencing myself to be, I'm experiencing it through the medium of the
mind
or body. Here, understand this. And now we are trying to retrace by coming to the I thought, then going beyond the I thought to the original one. Because that we are all the time, no? It's not a concept for us. I am conscious is not a concept. I may be a concept because it comes and goes. But the consciousness is not a concept for me. Yeah. But which consciousness you are talking about? The reflected consciousness or the pure consciousness?
The pure consciousness. Because consciousness is...
Yeah, but how will body, which has got no capacity to think of pure consciousness except through words, come to experience the pure consciousness except through reflected light?
But what about the role of awareness through consciousness?
Conscious. When consciousness expresses through the mind, it is called awareness. That's all. You are aware of something, or you are aware of yourself. And when you say I am aware of myself, you are aware of the I thought, of your existence, of your... But that is not the original. It will take you to the original. So when I am saying, just very good point, exactly that what is was told in the example of the sun. You cannot know the sun with sunlight unless you see the sunlight which is expressing in the atmosphere through the medium. So where do you experience, what is the medium where you experience the conscious light? The mind. In that mind, where does it shine very brightly like it is shining here? In the intellect. How does it shine in the intellect? As I thought. What happens in the rest of the mind? It is all the other thoughts. And that phenomena is going on. But this idiot I, he says, all those other thoughts are my thoughts. I own them. And he gets identified. He says, oh, the body thought came. Oh, I am the body. Instead of saying, this body is. A small child, you listen to the small child when they speak. They don't speak to that I am the body or I am hungry. They say, whatever their name is, Lavanya. Lavanya is hungry. Lavanya is going to school. Where is Lavanya's back? They talk about themselves in third person. Mahatmas also speak about themselves in third person. Only stupid idiots talk in first person. That's us.
Like that. In Kerala also they speak.
In Sanskrit like that. Also they speak like that only. That's why
Kerala,
I teach Sanskrit.
In
all languages, that was the way to speak. Always in plural. Either you say in we, so in that I is melted, or you speak in third person.
Sri Anandamaya stories.
Huh?
Sri Anandamaya always never use I, always use this body.
This body.
This body.
Yesterday I gave you that example of Shankar Maharaj. He felt hungry. Oh, this body is feeling hungry. He didn't say, I am feeling hungry, because he is attending the classes.
This body is called this body.
Yes. If someone says, when you are born, I am unborn. No, Swamiji, come to reality. That is reality. If you ask a Mahatma, they say that way. Then ask the right question. Acharya Swamiji, which country you were born? No, I am not born. I am countryless. Until unless they don't ask that. Swamiji, where was this body born? Acha, now we will answer you. Because they don't consider this body to be theirs. And many Mahatmas, sannyasis, if you ask, they will say, this body was born here, this body is got this dharma, this body is born to this mother, or this body's mother is this person. Mother may not like it, but that is the way, because they are on their journey of disassociation. In that, no relations can come and corrupt that journey. Exactly the same way, what we have been seeing in the previous few chapters is, no other thought must come and hijack the I to associate with it. That is the alertness and vigilance that is required.
No. Say my father or mother, no, take the body out, or you know, put it in the coffin or something, and that is the only time we say.
Yes,
body,
yes, yes. We talk about third
say,
person.
Yeah.
Otherwise, we are talking about the person, considering them to be the body.
Yeah.
Yes. So either when you are young, and your brain has not kicked in, 100%, memories have not kicked in, then you speak in that language, or you have to die to be spoken of in that language. Two extremes. In between, we'll remain ignorant. That is our lot. Then, in the next verse.
But we don't say how are you, we say how.
How are?
How is your body? It's literal translation.
Yeah. Where's your intention? How are you? And the person answers, yaar, I'm not well, yaar. And he says, what happened? You're not addressing the consciousness, you're addressing the body.
So
isn't it?
Hai, huh? Don't say, how are you? How are you is an English term.
Hum Hindi mein kya bolte hain?
Tabiyat kaisi
hai? Haan, tabiyat bola toh phir theek hai na. Hum aise bhi bol sakte hain, aap kaise hain? Aap kaise hain? And all you have to say, you want to be positive, sab theek hai na? गलती कर दी सब ठीक है ना मीन्स इज एवरीथिंग ऑल राइट एंड यू थिंक इफ समवन आस्क मी स्वामी जी हाउ आर यू आई से बेटर देन यू स्टोरी ओवर दैट पर्सन तब तक अपना निकल जाओ बट इफ आई आस्क देम हाउ इज एवरीथिंग ऑल राइट इट्स लाइक आई हैव ओपन्ड द लॉक एंड नाउ दे आर फ्री टू डाउनलोड ऑन मी So here he says in the next verse, sixth verse, Sukshmanam vidyudadinam Sthule tantryadike yatha Tatha kalebare nadhyam Chaitanya jyotisho gatihi So in the sixth verse he says, even as the subtle forces like the electric current passes through the visible wires, the light of awareness flows through a nadi in the body. And this is now coming to, he is explaining in a different way. Kundalini also explains the same way, that that this the unseen electric current. What is the kundalini in the bulb? The straight line of filament. Aajkal to filament ki bhi pata nahi kya. LED mein filament hota hai kya? pata nahi. In the old bulbs, that is, what is the nadi where the current flows in you? Kundalini is the shakti, it is the current, which is the one where the shakti or the awareness, shakti is awareness, we are not talking about pure consciousness, its expression is this. Where is it functioning? In the sushumna. Then sushumna bifurcates itself into two. Why? Because of body identification. Then it bifurcates into more and more and more. How many channels are there in your body? 72,000. So that one became 72,000. But for that one to become 72,000, the first one was sushumna. Now what are we doing? Remember yesterday, we are retracing from manyness to oneness. So from those 72,000, we are going back to its source. What is that which became 72,000? Oh, I don't know. But from these 72,000, I know about the 10 main ones, you know. Oh, acha? Oh, from where did these 10 main ones come? Oh, I know the two from where these two which became 10. Acha, let's go to the two. Then from two, where these two came? Oh, they came from the one. Then you go to the sushumna. This is exactly what is happening from gross speech to subtle speech. From subtle speech to unmanifest speech. From unmanifest speech to infinite speech, the para. Gross awareness, subtle awareness, causal awareness, infinite awareness. And this current has to be maintained. But what we do? We are not maintaining that current. We are not maintaining that awareness.
So infinite speech is what? Silence.
What?
The infinite speech is silence.
It's eloquent silence. It is conscious silence. Deep sleep is silence. Inert silence. This is conscious silence. You understand the difference? Yeah. So don't, you have to understand the implication of the words that you are using also. So this current through the just as the unseen electric current passes through the visible wires, the flame of consciousness flows through the various channels of the body. Exactly the same way it is happening in our body. How do you know that life is, that there is something called consciousness, there is something called awareness, there is something called sentiency? Because we can experience it throbbing through us. Right now it is, heart is throbbing, breath is coming in and out, sometimes disease is throbbing, sometimes muscle is throbbing. It's all different throbs all over the body. You want to come back to the original throb. You want to come back to the original throb. That is in the heart. That is in the heart. For that you have to come to the eye. Only then you can get there. And as whether you practice Kundalini or Kriya or you practice self-inquiry, the goal must be clear. And that goal is that if you are doing the inquiry, automatically your channels are getting purified. Because if you are doing the inquiry or mind control, your mind is getting purified, isn't it? If mind is getting purified, your channels are getting purified where the energy is passing through. Because where is this body? Tell me. It is a thought in your mind. So mind alone has projected the form of the body. Just like mind alone projects the entire dream world where human beings are there, animals are there, they are breathing, they are thinking, they are born, they are dead, mountains, air, space, fire, water, earth, rivers, everything, past, present, future, everything the mind is projecting on the screen of itself in the dream. Same way, in the waking also, this body is only a projection in the mind. And until unless mind is not integrated, the body, its expression through the body, which is as energy or awareness, that will not be integrated. And the moment mind starts getting integrated, what is integration of the body? Okay, you can say that what you think is what you speak is what you do. Integration of the body also means that on account of body you do not get disturbed. On account of whatever you want or the mind says, body, you have to do this. Body has got no say in it. It will follow without, no, we sat for 4 hours, it's too much now, it's time to go and lie down in our bed a little bit. But mind is saying, yeah, I'm enjoying, I want to stay here, only one more class, last class, why you want to? But the body is saying, no, no, I got the hip ache, I got the back ache, I got the this ache or that ache. Sometimes it's not the ache, it's the ache of attachment. My grandchild is calling me, I promised my child that I will forsake satsang, but I will be there for you. This is what it is. So we have always something up our sleeve to sabotage our journey. Always. The mind has. Until unless it is integrated. And it will get integrated only when it is purified. Again, many times I'll repeat it. It will get integrated, synchronized, only when it is purified. And for it, at a physical level, the yogis say that when it is integrated, the energy is flowing only in the spinal cord, in the sushumna. It is not even becoming ida and pingla. The energy is there, but it's insignificant because the main flow is in and through the sushumna. If it is in vaikari, it is not in sushumna. If it is in madhyama, it is not in sushumna. If it is in vaikari madhyama, Pashyanti, it is not in Sushumna. Only when it reaches Para, it starts vibrating in the Sushumna. Only when the energy from Muladhar has reached the Sahasrar, then it is shunting between the Sushumna. See? The channel has to open up. And that is complete integration. And the moment channel opens up, the whole matrix called life, gone once and for all. You have to die to be resurrected. You have to die to yourself as you know yourself right now. Ron Maharshi says, you know yourself right now as I, this I has to die. And in different ways he is telling you. In the 7th verse he says, Sthalamekam upashritya Chaitanya Jyoti Rujvalam Sarvam bhasayate deham. Bhaskaro bhuvanam yatha. The effulgent light of pure awareness taking hold of a center lights up the entire body as the sun illumines the world. Just like this electricity taking hold of one point. What is that one point? The filament. It lights up the whole room. Isn't it? Exactly the same way. The pure consciousness taking hold of one point. What is the... It's the intellect. It comes there and it illuminates. The sunlight once it holds on to the atmosphere of the earth, then it illuminates the earth. If there is no atmosphere on the earth, there will be no sunlight as you know it. See? So here he says that the effulgent light of the pure awareness taking hold of a center. So where is that center? It is that center is the intellect, and where lights up the entire body as the sun illumines the world. Many yogis, if you read their experiences, or even in Patanjali Yoga Sutra or Kundalini Shastra or Kriya Yoga Shastra, if you read, you reach a level of integrity within yourself where the Sushumna is completely shining, and when it completely becomes integrated, no obstacles in between, suddenly instead of an energy you experience a bright sunlight. People experience a most effulgent sun on the seat of meditation. Initial experience is that, and then after that sun also goes away. The mind is ever awash with that light of the auspicious sun which they have experienced. See? So these are very, very physical, whichever path you may pass through, pursue, you will go through those type of experiences. That you hear sounds, that you hear the drums, and you different things are there. That you experience the light, you experience different colors. All those things happen. But those things are, we must not get lost. They are only signs to show that you are coming to your destination. You are coming to your destination. Policeman city bajata hai. Policeman on the road whistles. Why does he whistle?
To make us alert.
To warn you. To alert.
Is he, you know, if the police car is coming with the lights going, it could be coming to stop you because you have done something wrong. Or it could be coming to, as you said, warn you that there is danger ahead, be careful. Isn't it? So all these signs that come on the seat of meditation, Varun Maharaj is not getting lost in them, but we have to understand they are only indicators that you are moving, symptoms that you are moving in the right direction, but don't get lost in them. You continue to focus on the source of the eye. First understand where the eye is first, where it is appearing. So in the same example, like that example of the bulb and the light and everything, the self is the electricity, the filament is the intellect, the bulb is the body, the space between, inside the bulb is the space in your mind, and the phenomena is going on. If there is no space inside the bulb, if there is no space inside the bulb, will you get that much light? So if there is no mind, will you get the light? Can't. Life is giving us so many examples. Now don't think of yourself as a bulb. Don't think of yourself as a bulb. Be the consciousness. If you think of the bulb, again body identification. No, I am the pure filament. No, your attention should be on the electricity. Your attention should be on the pure consciousness. Next verse. Where are we? Verse number? 8.
Vyaptena tat prakashena
शरीरे त्वनुभूतयः स्थलं तदेव हृदयम् सूरयः संप्रचक्षते प्रचक्षते टंग ट्विस्टर ओके ओइंग टू द डिफरेंस ऑफ द ऑफ दैट लाइट इन द बॉडी वन हैज एक्सपीरियंसेस इन द बॉडी दैट सेंटर ऑफ रेडिएशन द सेजेस से इज द हार्ट फ्रॉम वेयर डिड दिस एफल्जेंस बिगिन From where did this knowledge begin within us? What is that point where knowledge is taking place? What is that point from where everything that I know, this body is there, I know the mind is there, I know the thoughts are there, I know the disease is there, I know the health is there, I know the joys are there, I know the sorrows are there. From where is this knowledge emanating from? That is the heart. And that is the I. And that is in the intellect. And intellect is that which does not exist. If you think of yourself as a body, there is intellect. How did you come to know about intellect? Because someone told you.
Yeah.
Have you ever seen intellect? Have you ever seen mind?
Never mind.
Exactly. So you start taking whatever is told as the truth. We are saying everything only to deny that we said it. That all this dialogue that is going on, it's foolish. And once you come to realize that all this is just, as you said, is going in circles, now keep it away. That you have taken a sakshi pose. That you saw that we are taking you in circles. Then you will say, "Acha, up now. What next? Again, you want to start the circle." This is the only way we can take you out of your own mind, or guide you. If I say mind, it is truth also, and it is false also. Now, then which one it is? Tell us clearly. I can't, because you can't. You know there is a mind, and yet you have never seen it. I can see my hand. I have a hand, I can see my hand. Where is the mind? Tell me. People say Kundalini. Tell me, show me where is Kundalini. But you experience it in the same manner. Our time ho gaya mere khayal se. Eighth verse. We'll start from the eighth verse next class. It's already 118. Ninth verse. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om. Sit quietly for a few minutes and bring your attention. Whatever you become aware, don't fight with anything that is coming in your mind. Your attention should be, from where is this attention coming from? That's where your attention should be. What is the source of this attention? Without initiating too much thinking in your mind, be available to the source of your attention, of the attention. For that you don't have to stop the thoughts. For that you don't have to change the position. For that you don't have to change the breath, increase or decrease. Wherever you are, whichever manner you are, whatever thoughts are there, to whom are these thoughts? And if you find yourself giving attention to that, yeah, I know this thought is there. Who is this I? From where did this I arise from? What is its source?